In today's report, we delve into a pressing global issue. The Israel-Hamas conflict, infamous for its intensity, is now seeping into Syria, fueling instability, violence, and uncertainty. This UN envoy has a dire warning for the world. The United Nations Special Envoy for Syria, Geir Pedersen, recently addressed the United Nations Security Council. He painted a grim picture, emphasizing that the situation in Syria is reaching a breaking point. The roots of this issue lie in the long-standing 12-year conflict in Syria. But now, the Israel-Hamas war has exacerbated the crisis, creating what Pedersen describes as a terrifying prospect of a potential wider escalation. Notably, this spillover into Syria is not merely a risk, it's already happening. Israel has conducted airstrikes on Syrian airports in Aleppo and Damascus multiple times, and the United States has retaliated against attacks on its forces, which they claim were carried out by groups backed by Iran, even within Syrian territory. The region is now at its most dangerous and tense. Pedersen highlights that the situation is adding fuel to an already volatile situation in Syria. Even before the recent events, violence was on the rise. The number of Syrians killed, injured, and displaced is now at its highest since 2020. There's been a significant intensification of attacks, particularly in government-controlled areas. A shocking unclaimed attack on a graduation ceremony at a military academy in Homs, attributed to terrorist organizations, is just one example of the escalating violence. Government rocket attacks in October targeted Hayat Tahrir al-Sham, the insurgent group that controls much of rebel-held northwest Syria. Additionally, Turkish strikes in the northeast escalated following an attack on Turkish government facilities in Ankara, resulting in casualties, damage to healthcare facilities, schools, and camps, and the displacement of over 120,000 civilians. The United States Ambassador, Linda Thomas Greenfield, expressed concerns about the use of Syrian territory by terrorist groups to plot and launch attacks against Israel. She also accused Syria of allowing Iran and these groups to use its international airports for military purposes. Russia's ambassador, Vasily Nebenzia, Syria's closest ally, accused Israeli forces of striking sites in Syria, including civilian airports. He termed U.S. attacks in Syria as illegitimate actions and a gross violation of Syria's sovereignty. Iran's UN ambassador, Amir Iravani, denied all U.S. claims, asserting that Iran is in Syria at Damascus's request to combat terrorism. He accused the U.S. of trying to shift blame from the culprits to the victims. It's important to note that Iran's primary goal is to prevent any further escalation in the region. They've endorsed international calls for an immediate ceasefire and humanitarian aid for the people in Gaza. Nonetheless, Iran made it clear that they will respond to any threat, attack, or aggression that endangers their security. In conclusion, the situation in Syria, already dire, is being further inflamed by the Israel-Hamas conflict, causing widespread instability and violence. The world watches closely as the international community grapples with how to address this complex and escalating crisis. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more updates on this developing story.